please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
Hello and welcome to a very special show to commemorate 25 years of the listing of Motherson Sumi, a company that has created a lot of wealth for shareholders in the past and a global auto ancillary player known to successfully buy and turn around companies in the auto parts business. Today on my show, I have the company of the men behind the successful business, Vivek Chaand Sehgal, the chairman, and his son, Laksh Vaaman Sehgal, the director of Motherson Sumi. Gentlemen, congratulations to both of you, Mr. Sehgal and Vaaman, on completing 25 years of listing. If you map the annual growth trends for Motherson Sumi, the business has grown from revenues of $1.5 billion in FY10 to an impressive $9.6 billion in FY18. That's a six-fold jump in the last 8 years. Vaaman, I want to start off with you because, you know, you're the future of the company now. What is your vision for the next 10 years?
I think, first of all, I want to thank all the investors who've had the faith in us and got us this far. And of course, to the management team here at Motherson that has shown such wonderful results for the last 25 years. I think the next 10 years are going to be super exciting with all the changes and things that are happening in the automotive industry. There's going to be a lot of opportunities for us at Motherson. But we at Motherson focus on our 5-year goals. So we are quite focused on the 2020 target at the moment. As you can imagine, we still have a little way to go, and all the teams are quite focused on making sure that we can deliver that target for 2020. So once we get close to that 2020 target, we will set the next 5-year plan for 2025, and hopefully that will give you a good color as to where we want to go in that 5-year period.
Okay, well, Mr. Sehgal, Motherson Sumi is your baby. You've told me in the past that, you know, you named the company Motherson because you and your mother started the company together. So tell us about the vision. You have a target of $18 billion revenues by 2020. I mean, you know, realistically, you can achieve about $11, $12 billion through the organic route by 2020. But the rest will definitely have to be done via acquisitions. What geographies, what areas are you looking at to achieve this target?
The ability of Motherson is to give you a top line with the bottom line. So, you know, the newspapers have been rife 3-4 years ago telling you that we would be acquiring companies which would have easily given us the top line. So really, it's all about 18 billion where we can have the visibility of delivering 40% growth to our investors. I think one of the biggest things that we are very grateful for is that our investors are very well attuned to the fact that it's not a top-line growth company. It's actually cash in the bank, or what we say, the ability to have a visual identification for the top line and bottom line. So while we have a lot of companies which are in the pipeline, which we have to acquire, if the things are right, and if we had the visibility. However, I would have no shame or hesitation to come back after 5 years and tell the investor that, sorry, I didn't find anything which was worthwhile for me to bring into the group. And I can't see the visibility of the bottom line. Hence, I'm sure my investors would be very, very happy to see that we may not have hit bang on 18 billion, but we definitely have met our bottom line targets. So it's all about a combination of these two things. If it was only top line, believe me, it's relatively very easy in these turbulent times. It's very easy to go and pick up companies just for the top line.
You know, I'm glad you used the word turbulent times because the industry dynamics are definitely changing rapidly. I mean, talk of electrification of vehicles, talk of a slowdown in consumption of luxury cars. achieving more content per vehicle is the need of the hour. Vaaman, how are you going to adapt to these changes? What is the plan that you have laid out for yourself?
We at Motherson are focusing on 3CX15. That means no customer, no component, no country should be more than 15% of our business. We've also announced that we are moving into rolling stocks. We're moving into different verticals as the times progress. So after this 2020 period, we will be looking at getting more exposure into not just the passenger cars, but also all the affiliates in the automotive world, and as well as some other sectors which are synergistic to the automotive, but will give us another exposure and drive future growth of Motherson for the next 5-year period. So you're absolutely right. These are some very interesting times. But if you can see the history that we are here to talk about a little bit of this 25 years, you know, in the last at least 15 years, we've seen some of the most tumultuous times that we've seen in recent history. So, and that has thrown up a lot of opportunities. In fact, SMR was bought at a time of the recession. So we believe that you know, these are times where more opportunities will come up. And we have to just make sure that we are patient and we have the financial discipline and go after these opportunities at the right time.
I'm going to take you up on that, Vaaman, because, you know, you joined at the time when SMR was, you know, was being bought over, at a time when there was so much trouble. So it was almost like baptism by fire. I'll come to that in a bit. But Mr. Sehgal, you've said in the past that you're targeting 20% of your business to come from the non-auto segment by FY25. I understand you may want to sort of diversify, but can you elaborate? What are the non-auto segments that you would be looking at, say, over the next few years? Medical, railways, is something that you have mentioned in the past. Any technology partners that you will be looking at?
Definitely. I think medical devices. You know, look at the Australian case of Motherson, if you please. That's in October 2017, Australia stopped producing cars totally. We have plants over there. They have completely pivoted out from automotive and gone into medical devices and things like that. They're doing very well. They're all profit-making. So the ability to understand turbulence and then take it to your advantage is one of the great things that our team do very well. I think the other very strong point that we have is we are really agnostic to half the things that people are looking at for disruptions. I do not agree with you that the luxury car segments are coming down in Europe and in America. If anything, it's actually going the other way. I think where the pain is that the governments, the car makers, the people in general are trying to figure out what is the real thing which is going to pass them that particular benefit of cleaner fuels or cleaner air or whatever is the conditions over there. I think half the people do not even know what's really happening. So it's a lot of news on news that's coming. We really don't know which is the right way to go. 10 years ago, half the technologies that we are talking about today didn't exist. And 10 years from now, since you keep talking about 10 years from now, really nobody knows what's going to be the new technologies that are going to come and disrupt the whole world. So I think in such a scenario, what we are trying to tell Motherson people is that you have to be on your toes. You have to be very quick to respond, very quick to change, very quick to be able to take advantage of the trends and the things that are coming in the coming times. So that's what Vaaman and me think are very, very exciting times because, you know, you have the right people, you have the right equipment, you have the plants, you have the geographical advantage to yourself. And amazing kids are coming out from universities. So really exciting times for us. We are really we feel that it's really going to be fun when we're going in the next 5-10 years.
Well, fun not just for you, Mr. Sehgal, it's fun for your shareholders as well. I mean, Vaaman, you know, your shareholders have been enjoying this wealth quite a bit. You just announced a 1:2 bonus as well on Friday, last Friday, to commemorate 25 years of listing. What are the other plans to return wealth to shareholders? You know, your dividend payout ratio has improved quite a bit. It was 29% in 2016. It went to 33% in 2017, 36% in 2018. Is it going to get better? What's the stated objective over the next few years?
We will come out with the next five-year plan, but at least till 2020, we want to maintain this dividend ratio payout. Like you've rightly said that, you know, we've said that we are going to introduce Motherson into new sectors out of automotive as well. So we will need investments for that. And I think we will plan all of that out. But till 2020, I think all the dividend payout ratios and our goals are very, very clearly slated for us and for the entire team. And we'll focus on that till 2020. And then I think, you know, from the 2020 to 2025 period, we will come, we'll discuss, see what's required and come back to the market with something that's exciting. And of course, we'll not be short on growth either, because Motherson is a growth-focused company. And I believe that the next five-year period as well, we want to show a lot of growth.
Also, Vaaman, I think what is very important is that we guys have a lot of fun in whatever we do, right? So it's not something that, you know, which is going to kill us, that the times and all these things are so fantastic. But I think to add on to what you're saying is the dividend payout policy is a slated goal of the company. In the last 25 years, there's not even 1 year where we have skipped the dividend or something like that. We've always increased the dividend, I think, by and far. Every year we have increased that. In the Lehman crisis, we had the best cash flows of the company. And so that focus that the group has on cash and profitability and the ability to plow back into the group is something very, very important. And on the lighter side, Sonia, both Vaaman and we would desperately need the dividend so that we can be staying alive.
I'm sure your shareholders need it much more than you. You know, I was just looking at the camaraderie that both of you share. I mean, the rapport. Vaaman, you have a great legacy to learn from, right? I mean, over the last 20 to 25 years, your father has literally built this company. He's turned around so many ailing auto component companies. I mean, I've lost track of it. 20 companies is what he's bought in the last 10, 11 years. For you, what has the biggest learning been?
Sonia, I'm constantly learning. I think every time I learn something new, I realize there's a lot more for me still to learn. I think I had a wonderful experience when we took over SMR, the company, in the time of the recession. And I was rated as the CEO for that company. I think my real MBA really happened at that time. I was constantly learning from my father. We had a wonderful team that was together with me, working to turn that company around. I learned a lot from our customers. They taught us also a lot, because without their support, a lot of these things would not really happen. I could sit down and chat with you all day about like all the things that I've learned. But I think the biggest thing that I take forward with me is that the main focus of our company, that, you know, top line is vanity. It's really the bottom line that really matters. It's the trust of the customers that we have to make sure that we never break. And our name is really important. So these are three really guiding principles for us. And we make sure that we act as the same company as we did 10 years ago or 25 years ago as we move forward. And we don't break our financial discipline, because that's something that no matter how tough the times have been, the financial discipline and that focus has really helped us to turn these companies around. And that's something that we should maintain and not get carried away just by the top line targets, like my father was saying before. So these are very strong foundations that I think to my father and together the team, we all have put into the company. And we're a completely professional organization. So we are adding a lot of younger people into the company. Companies that are also pushing the company forward, that are joining the family. We've just announced Radel that has come in. Another 20 plants that have come in, more than 5,000 people that have joined the family. So there's a lot of stuff that is going on. The family is growing. And like I said, everyone's quite focused on the 2020 target. And, 2020, we'll all sit down as one big family, regroup, rethink what is the next five-year plan, and share all the learnings that we've had and make sure that we don't lose them.
Okay, yeah, you know, I was actually reading about the number of acquisitions and about how much you have to learn from your father. I understand he travels almost 300 days in a year and he has a really hectic schedule, so there's so much to learn from him. But if you look at the number of companies, what, 20 acquisitions since 2002? I'm sure you take all the decisions now, Vaaman. What acquisitions would you be looking for? Will it be in the wiring harness business? Is plastic moldings looking good? Rearview mirror business? I mean, where do you see scope for growth, and which are the geographies that would interest you?
Sonia, we don't wake up in the morning and look at companies and say, okay, let's go attack this company today or buy it. It's all coming from the customer's behest. We've always followed the customer on that. So, and I don't think that's going to change. As we move move forward. Definitely, as we move into different verticals, we might have to change a different strategy for that. But at least in the automotive space, the customers have always stood right behind us, supporting us, pushing us forward. And without them, we are really nothing, because we are quite focused on a 100% OEM supplier company. So, you know, it's always going to be make sure that we are really close to the car makers, to all the automotive majors. Make sure that we keep our pulse on what they want us to do, and make sure that we keep delivering to their expectations and far exceeding them.
Okay, well, I have a lot more questions for you guys, so don't go anywhere. I'm going to take a short commercial break, but we'll be back on the other side of the break to discuss some lighter elements, some father's relationship, what it takes to make Motherson Sumi such a big conglomerate. More on that on the other side. Stay with us.
Indiabulls Commercial Credit Limited, a 100% subsidiary of Indiabulls Housing Finance Limited, is doing a public issue of securities rated CRISIL AAA and NAAA. Issue open for subscription. Interest rate of up to 9.20% for 10 years on a first-come, first-served basis. For risk factors, refer prospectus available on SEBI, exchanges, and the Indiabulls website.
Babe, pizza order. I dumped him.
Sujata bhi Paris pahunche.
Arre kaap ho.
Tu kab se keh rahe ho?
Geeta, second honeymoon ke liye Paris chalenge.
Eiffel Tower छोड़ कुतुब मीनार तक तो नहीं दिखाया
सर्दी में जाने
डैड के हाल में छोड़ टाटा कैपिटल से रिश्ता
टाटा कैपिटल
क्विक क्विक पर्सनल लोन के लिए दो से एक ही नाम
Welcome back. You're still watching this very special show where we are celebrating 25 years of the listing of Motherson Sumi with the men behind the company, Vivek Chaand Sehgal and his son, Laksh Vaaman Sehgal. Gentlemen, thank you for your journey over the last 25 years. But let's look at the way forward, right? Mr. Sehgal, over the next 10 years, what is your vision? You did speak about how you're looking to diversify the business, de-link from autos. How much will the revenues be from autos? How much from non-autos? And within non-autos, where do you think the moolah will come from? Is it railways? Is it medical? Is it defense?
Sorry, honestly, what we are doing is we're just seeding. We're putting good seeds in. We're looking at different things that is happening all across the globe. We're looking at what is the pivot strategy of Motherson? What are the equipments that we have? What are the technologies that we have? And how we are going to pivot a portion of our capacities into these new territories, if you please. I think, again, here, the Vaaman and the team is sitting together. There is a huge new young Turks, as you say, in one of your programs. The youngsters are coming in, and they're talking about where they want to see some new seeding and things like that coming. I think defense and more the offset of the defense is interesting. Medical devices are interesting. Aerospace is very interesting, yes. I think these are all new areas where these the younger generation and Motherson wants to go. So we have a very clear work cut out. Me and my team are focusing on delivering what the targets for 2020 are. Vaaman takes care of those particular companies that are not up to the mark or not delivering what they had promised that they will, and hence improving the overall efficiency of the group. And also, in his spare time, whichever little he has, he does look at the new startups, the new things. So he has, we have a whole floor of young startups and things like that which are happening, which are being brought about with our group synergy. See, we have about 250-70 plants all over the world. We have a lot of technology, a lot of equipments and things like that. So how do you actually build on that? And those startups become that much more relevant and that much more important for our group, because that's a way forward. And to answer your question on after 2020, I think my kind of gut feeling is that we would be of a size of somewhere around the top 15 auto component suppliers in the world. And probably that year we would look for either 80-20 in automotive and non-automotive, or 70-30, depending upon the exuberance and the confidence that the youngsters have in the next group meeting. You know, all these targets are set by about 225 of us getting together and actually discussing out. And it's a very, very interesting discussion that takes place. It's normally a 3 or 4 days offsite that we do. So really looking forward to that somewhere around in 2020, May, June, probably somewhere there it will happen.
But you talked about the startups being, you know, an essential part of the business. I mean, things are changing so fast, Mr. Sehgal. What do you think will be the future of this industry? I mean, you know, what are we looking at now? Will the same product sell? Will it be a different set of products, dramatically different industry? And is the next, I know Vaman is sitting next to you, but be honest and tell me, is the next generation capable of handling this change?
We constantly learn from the younger generation. I think today, if the younger generation was not as demanding as they are, probably the globe wouldn't have brought out all these new things. So every single new or thing that has come out because there is a huge pent-up demand for these particular products, services, and things like that. What's amazing is the ability to not give up. What these youngsters have in them. We learn that all the time. We see that all the time. They work 24/7. They are focused on that. And I think very rightly said, you ignore the youngsters at your own peril. You have to listen to them because they are your future customers. They are the future for any business, in fact, why just automotive? We have understood one particular thing very, very well, and that is the ability to translate good features, things, and all these things, and bring them down in the cascading effect, down to the value that they are willing to pay for it. And I think that learning is a very, very important learning amongst a lot of other learning. But I think it's equal both ways. You know, the youngsters are learning from the elders are also learning from the youngsters. And in that case, there is harmony. And harmony always creates beautiful music.
Yeah, that's a really nice way to put it. But, you know, Vaman, I just wanted to end with you. As we were mentioning earlier, when you started off as the CEO of SMR, it was literally baptism by fire for you. I mean, SMR was ailing, losses were mounting, and you were made CEO right at that time. What was the biggest learning for you?
Sonia, I mean, that was a tough time when we started. And on the lighter note, I still am young, but I feel like at that time I was like almost like a kid when I went into that business because I didn't have the experience that I do now, 10 years later. But on the lighter note, my father told me that, no, don't worry, son. You know, it's already bankrupt, so you can't do any worse. So I think that kind of took a little bit of the pressure off, you know. So when a business is that far down, all you really need is a hungry, motivated team that's willing to take up that challenge, because the downside is very limited and there is huge unlimited upside up there. So I think our biggest learning was that, you know, as soon as we got in there, we saw so many problems that were there, and trying to tackle all of them at once would be spreading ourselves too thin. So we, together with the team, made a priority list and went out on, you know, which is the biggest problem that we can solve right now, which would give us some breathing room, and kind of float with the rest of them till we don't solve some of the priority problems that we had. And I think that was a big learning for me, that, you know, even though there may be a lot of things that you want to focus on, but it's important to prioritize and make sure the team is on board to go and lick those problems first. And, you know, things kind of fall into place. So once you taste a little bit of success and you solve a couple of those problems, you know, the team gets motivated, the customers are a little bit happier, and you're making progress rather than trying to, you know, go after everything at one time. And, you know, my father constantly guided me. I really had a wonderful team that were working together with me in solving the problems. And, you know, thanks to the customer support who was standing behind us to make sure that we were successful, we were able to do that. And slowly and steadily, as we started solving some of the initial problems, you know, we got more confidence, we were more motivated, and the rest is history. And the team has done even a better job since I've left that position. That goes to speak that, you know, professionals are much better at driving the business here at Motherson than family. So the full credit to the team. They're the ones that did this wonderful job. And together with Papa's guidance, I'm just truly feeling blessed and quite humbled by everything that this team has achieved.
Okay, I do see the lovely camaraderie and mutual understanding between the two of you, like any father and son should have, right? But I'm sure there are professional differences, as there is in every organization. So if you had to change one thing about your son, what would that be, Mr. Sehgal? And Vaaman, same question to you. What would you want to change about your father?
I would not change anything about him. I love his bubbliness. I like his focus. And frankly, no parent ever minds spending more money on the kids. So I wouldn't want to change anything about him.
Papa, I say the same. I mean, we're really blessed to have such an amazing relationship. And, you know, you just got to be grateful for what you have. And I think no better father in this world than what I have. And I'm just grateful that he continues to teach me, guide me, mentor me. Sure, we have our times when we debate things till cows come home. But at the end of the day, you know, it all works out. So truly grateful and feeling very, very, very blessed.
Okay, on that very emotional note, thank you so much, gentlemen, for joining me and discussing the journey that Motherson Sumi has had over the last 25 years. And I wish you very, very well. I wish that your shareholders also reap the benefits that you've seen over the last many years. Thank you so much. With that, it's curtains down on this very special story. Thanks so much for watching. Do stay tuned into CNBC TV18 for all the news and action.